Hello everybody and welcome back to a brand new episode of our F1 23 Driver Career Mode here on the channel. I hope you're all having a great day. Today we're headed to Zandvoort for the Dutch Grand Prix. It's been an interesting start to the season that's been swept all by McLaren. Alex Albon with 3 wins to kick off the season, but we saw Aiden Jackson pick up his first win in China in the last episode as we picked up a runner-up finish, P2, as we were headed into the home race of Max Verstappen. A big race for him, looking for his first podium of the season, and we had a team meeting with Horner and Verstappen headed into the weekend. Take a listen.
All right, guys, we've had a solid start to the year, but we still need more if we want to challenge McLaren. We're targeting a winning car by mid-season, so I just need you two to hang in there while you can.
And what if McLaren keeps upgrading?
They don't have the long-term resources that we do, Max. We will be winning races soon.
You hear the optimism there from team principal Christian Horner and Verstappen bringing up the question about, you know, what if McLaren continues to upgrade? But Red Bull Ford, it's been a solid start. We've had a couple of good runs so far. We've had a couple of rough, you know, days as well, including, of course, the season opener in Australia there in Albert Park. We never got to finish. But we roll through into Zandvoort here. Free practice on Friday. A bit of an overcast afternoon, but no threat of rain coming into this episode. Still going to be another episode without rain in the Grand Prix. It's been a dry season so far. However, we have Imola coming in the next episode, and we often see rain there, so I would not be too surprised to, you know, see some wet weather action on track in the Grand Prix Sunday for Imola. But nonetheless, finishing up free practice one, pretty content with where the car was. You know, it's not the best thing in the world right now. We still got some work to do if we're going to challenge the McLarens. We know we can bring the fight to Mercedes. We've proven that. We had the big run in last episode with Lando Norris, and Toto Wolff and Christian Horner had their little bit of a chat there going on, a bit of a, you know, argument about the racing that apparently I was a bit too aggressive in Toto's eyes. We're in our fourth season of Formula One. We're an established veteran at this point here, and we're trying to win races, but we focus in on Q1 here Saturday afternoon. And Q1, a breeze to really get out of it. It was a rough first lap, however, so I only went P10, but that would be enough to get me through into Q2. But I did make a second lap to be safe, and I just followed Gasly the whole time. I only improved by about a tenth, but I definitely had more time in it. But yeah, we still advanced into Q2, not by a whole lot, P13, while Verstappen is currently in fifth, for almost 5 tenths back from pole. Lawson, Hughes, Zhou Guanyu, Callie Mayer, and Devin Butler all out here now as we come into Q2, diving down deep into turn one, maybe a little bit too deep there, not quite hitting the apex the way I would like to slash need to, but we come through the long sweeping right-hander here, and another mistake right there, going a little bit wide again, so it was a bit of a sloppy lap one here in Q2 to say the least, so it wasn't going to be pretty, but we are going to see now as we come to the end of the lap, the time, just it wasn't looking great. It was looking like I was going to need to make another lap. I only go P9, so I was pretty confident a second lap was going to be necessary. Everybody, of course, going to be improving, and then I'm making a mistake right there immediately, but we do still find 2.5 tenths until right here, going a little bit wide again, and we lose a little bit of it. Same two corners, the first two laps, we've screwed up the same parts now, as we now make it even worse. I go wide again, and I just threw this lap away, so I had to focus in on the lap 3 at this point. We're still in, but now down to P10. We have found time again, down to P11 at this point. A tenth of a second better. Of course, the time getting slower and slower as we continue to put wear on the tires, but right now, this will get us into Q3. It really isn't that hard to make it into Q3, but now it is because we've spun it around, and that's it. We're not going to make Q3 because of my own errors. All 3 laps in Q2, we had the pace. The pace is not an issue, and you can see we only missed Q3 by half a tenth of a second, not even. So the pace was fine. The driving wasn't. Embarrassing. Let's head to the grid and see what we can do.
For years, the passionate Dutch fans have been easy to find trackside in races across Europe. Here this weekend, it's even easier to find the Dutch fans as they have a race to call their own once again. A warm welcome to all of our viewers in the Netherlands and around the globe, of course, as we get underway for the Dutch Grand Prix. 4 lefts and 10 rights make up the 14 corners of the narrow and demanding Zandvoort circuit, with plenty of peaks and valleys over the course of the 2.6-mile lap, which will demand absolute concentration from our drivers here today. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. What a great lap from Alexander Albon yesterday. He'll start from pole position, and it's Aiden Jackson alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Russell, Norris, Verstappen, Tsunoda, Oscar Piastri, Leclerc, Sainz, Ocon, Golden Boy, Iwasa, Gasly, Drugovic, Teo Porcher, Liam Lawson, Hughes, Joe, Butler, and Cali Mayer. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out then. Let's see who can prevail today. And joining me again for the race today, Natalie Pinkham. Now, can I get your take on Max Verstappen? Looks like they have a tough race in store today, as grid penalties from changing power unit components has forced them further down the field.
But on the bright side, at least those fresh components can help them maintain the power they need to come through the pack. I expect to see them take a much more aggressive approach today to make up for that compromised start.
It was not pretty in qualifying. P11, we're going desperate. You know, instead of mediums to hards, we're doing soft to mediums. Try to make a statement right off the bat here. Let's get ready to roll.
Here we go then. The formation lap gets underway and the excitement here is building as we near ever closer to the start of the race. Which team will come out on top? Who's got their strategies right for today's race? Well, we'll soon find out.
Mercedes again splits their drivers. Russell, mediums, Norris, softs. Both myself and Verstappen on softs in the back half of the grid, all starting on that red striped tire here in Zandvoort.
As the cars come back towards the grid to line up for the start of the race, each driver will be wanting to get the best start they possibly can. And they'll be hoping to finish today's race on the podium, failing that within the points.
Sorry about qualifying, guys. I'll try to make it up to you today.
No sweat, mate. Bring us some points today.
Ready to roll, and we've had a few moments so far, with this Red Bull where we've made some mistakes. I think the crash in Spain in the Grand Prix, and now we have this moment in qualifying. It's a bit of a learning curve with this Red Bull car and how it drives, but let's see what we can do today. Now, Zandvoort, historically not been the greatest track for myself, so we'll see what we can do. Hopefully we can hold our own as we get ready to roll for the Dutch Grand Prix here in the Netherlands. Five red lights, it's going to be... lights out, we're racing here for the Dutch Grand Prix. Now it's a decent start, but not good for Piastri. We're going to go four wide briefly, split through the middle. Alex Albon didn't get away well up there. It's Zayden Jackson out in front. Albon down to fourth. I nearly have a run-in with both the Ferrari, the teammates there of Leclerc, as well as Carlos Sainz. Russell second. It's going to be Norris third, followed by Albon versus Verstappen right there in front of Yuki Tsunoda. And we settle in right now off the banking there behind the two sets of Ferrari cars. In the background, some fighting already. I got Oscar Piastri as well, a little bit further behind. Behind me as well. You got the Alpines going at it, and look at this. Drugovic going for a move, an aggressive move. Does he get the job done? The Formula One rookie this season, of course, really trying to make some headlines here. He has had a solid rookie season so far, but his teammate of Ayumu Iwasa in his second season in Formula One has been doing significantly better than what we saw from Ayumu in season number one. I was surprised to see him back for season two with how rough of a rookie season he had, but BMW, gave him a second chance, and it might just pay off for them now as we come through towards the same spot on track. Lap number two now at this point, approaching the DRS being activated here on lap three. And right behind Carlos Sainz, just really pushing hard to stick with them. These soft tires weren't really taking off to the expectation that I had. And I mean, you could see that. It was taking a while. Lap four, with the help of DRS, is what got me to the back of Sainz. And we're going to get aggressive here. Trying to go around the outside on the banking. Sainz can't quite open up the wheel on the exit. Nearly some contact with the Spaniard. We get the job done. Up into P8. You got to get a bit aggressive sometimes when the car just isn't quite there for you. And that's kind of what I was feeling today. Now with yellow flags in the background, that's Pierre Gasly with an engine failure in the Alpine. It's going to be day over for the Frenchman. And he's right in the path of Iwasa Drugovic on back, and that just puts a huge gap between them and his teammate of Esteban Ocon. Battles now happening in front. Norris on the softs. It really does seem like the softs aren't really taking off for anybody, Russell, Verstappen, or myself. But now Norris is able to go around the outside, take second place as Jackson is driving away. Picked up his first career win last episode. Is he about to go back to back, get those first two wins in Formula One in what would be a very impressive fashion, to say the least here now? But I was over a second behind, Leclerc and the others numbers, but fortunately for me, look at this, we got these battles happening, so this is going to allow me to, of course, close in on them. Norris, Russell continuing to go at it, the two Mercedes teammates, new teammates, of course, this year. Norris fades back, it really does seem like the softs just haven't gone anywhere, and you can see Norris under more pressure towards the end of the lap now in the next DRS zone. That's Alex Albon going for third, not been the great race for him. Of course, he was doing so good in the first three Grand Prix he won, he was, you know, dominating China. A red flag comes out, changes everything here for him, and now not a great start today, but he's moving his way forward. Verstappen now putting some pressure on Lando Norris, so the fights continue, and I think Verstappen might get the job done right here. Maybe not. Norris has the edge going into the banked curve, and Verstappen tries to go the long way around, and Norris hangs on, but you can see a lap later, lap 9, he would breeze around the outside into turn 1, so the soft's not really kicking off, and Norris starting to really struggle. You have to wonder if he heated up his tires maybe a bit too much, but all that battling at least allowed me to finally, on lap 9, get into the DRS of Charles Leclerc. Took way longer than it should have, and what I would prefer, of course, now, but look at this. Norris now under pressure from Yuki Tsunoda. I think Norris is going to be dropping down behind Tsunoda, Leclerc, myself, and maybe even Piastri as well. The Aston Martins really have some pace today here in Zandvoort now, but we know the Red Bull Ford really excels on the long run, so that's what I was hoping for here today. Now we have a big run, but now you can see Leclerc going to force a three wide with Norris and Tsunoda. Norris in the middle. There was a bit of contact there. Now we make a bit of contact with the back of Norris there. Of course, no love lost between the two of us after our battles and contact with each other in China. We're going to dive around the outside of Norris. He gets a better run through the banking. Now we're going to swing back to the left, nearly driving into the back of him again. And I'm not going to make it easy on Lando Norris after the way we went at it in the last episode in Shanghai. Side by side, now into the grass a little bit there, dipping the left sides off. Norris can't quite hit the gas as hard as he wants. We still continue side by side. He finally backs up it. Job done. That was intense. Really risky to try and go around the outside through that whole long sweeping right-hander. Of course, that series of right-handers, like three of them, you know, in a row, as I have a bit of a power slide there on the exit of the corner. But the job done on Norris, and now we can focus ahead. Can we run down Leclerc and pass him? And Yuki Tsunoda as well. They're right here in front of us now. And you can see we close up right to the back. That long run pace in this Red Bull Ford starting to kick in. And you can see as we head towards the banking on lap 13 now, we're going to go for the same move on Leclerc that we tried on his teammate signs. This time can't quite make it work there, but we get a nice run on the exit. We'll swing back to the left side here. We'll be wheel to wheel up the elevation now. Tsunoda loving what he sees in his mirrors now as we continue. Oh, a little bit of contact right there between myself and the Monaco-based driver. Norris right here about a tenth behind, but the job done. We go around Norris. It seems like the AI really struggled to commit when they are on the inside of someone in that right-hander there. They kind of backed out of it. But we were now coming up on the pit window, so I tried to close in on Tsunoda as much as I could, but lap 15, that's just basically as close as I could get, and I royally screw up the pit entry. I didn't realize, I forgot the pit entry line was this far away, and then watch this. Yep, it got even worse. I screwed up the turn-in, so now we're gonna have a slow pit stop as well. So we had a slow pit entry, a slow pit stop. That allows Norris to exit right on my rear wing. So we're gonna head back out on the track after a 3-second pit stop. Not pretty. That's gonna be, you know, a bit of a setback to say the least here. Now, to be interesting to compare, you know, how far Verstappen is in front of me when he comes in and makes his pit stop. He was about like 3 or so seconds ahead when I came in right there, so we'll have to wait and see what it looks like here momentarily, as I expect him to pit at the end of this lap. I actually get a warning for exceeding track limits. Norris stuck with me all lap long, and now he has DRS. We only had it because of Calimera in front of us, side by side, wheel to wheel, forcing him all the way to the pit wall. There we go into turn one, wheel to wheel. Norris backs out of it. We stay ahead. Verstappen exits 5 seconds ahead, just about. So you can see how much time I gave up, but the battle wasn't over with Norris. That DRS, I just couldn't hold him back. He's going to go and take the position here into turn one as the pit cycle completes itself just about. Leclerc is going to exit behind us on the hard compound tire. Still a few cars yet to come into their box now over the next lap or two. Here comes Alex Albon now. Let's see what he can do. He's going to be putting on the hard compound tire as well. Russell in, actually, sorry, I believe they're on mediums now, but Piastri in as well, signs to follow. We're going to pass all those guys, at least the Ferrari Ferrari and the Aston Martin will be P7 right on the back of Lando Norris. And I believe that's, yeah, that should be where we cycle out as P7. Aiden Jackson, dominant Grand Prix so far. He's in the pits and he will get some fresh rubber, head back out on track. And it's going to be really a cruise of victory at this point for him, unless something, you know, goes catastrophically wrong. No, Albon is on the hard. Sorry, I was expecting, some maybe even sauce for him to attempt, but not quite the case now as we continue on. Just trying to stay within the DRS at this point of Lando Norris, because I know as the run goes on, of course, the car is going to get better, and that's exactly what's happening. Look at the run we have on Lando down towards turn one. We'll look up the inside again, wheel to wheel with him. Give him the racing room, of course, that he is deserving of, but we nonetheless get the job done pretty easily. He didn't really put up a huge fight right there. And now we're just kind of stuck with each other. You're at that point where you can't really get away from the guy behind you, and it just becomes a kind of back and forth DRS fight. And unfortunately, you know, none other than Lando Norris to fight at this point here now into turn one. He tried to go around the outside. I said, no, sir, we stay ahead for now. But yeah, this is just going to be one of those kind of back and forths probably for the final, 14 laps of this Grand Prix. And unfortunately, the cars behind us on the hard tires, Tsunoda, Leclerc, Piastri, they're all closing in on us while we continue to battle as well. So this is going to become a multi-car battle outside of myself and Norris here, certainly within the next few laps as we just continue to go at it now. Norris gets through. But what we're going to do now, coming to lap 27, 10 to go, let's go through the grid.
Aiden Jackson running away with the lead, now 8 seconds ahead of Alex Albon. Russell trying to fight off Verstappen in the closing laps for third.
Speaking of closing, here comes Owen for another charge at Lando Norris. This will be a pretty easy overtake for the Canadian, as these two just can't get away from each other lately, can they?
No, they cannot, as we see Tsunoda chasing both of them down in the background. Piastri as well is on the charge in eighth.
This is the closest that both Aston Martin and Ferrari have been to the Red Bull and Mercedes at this stage in a race so far. Either this track doesn't suit Red Bull and Mercedes, or the other two teams have brought some sneaky upgrades.
Williams runs 12th and 13th, BMW 14th and 15th, Alfa Romeo Haas 16th and 17th, and the two Konnersport cars in 18th and 19th in these final 10 laps.
And there you have, through the grid here in Zandvoort. Mayer and Butler rounding out the back of the grid as the two siblings continue to run close to one another. You saw through the grid as well, we were able to pass Norris, and Tsunoda was actually able to pass Norris as well on the hard. So Tsunoda was absolutely flying at this point here now, as it was turning into about a, four-car tussle. Myself, Tsunoda, Norris, as well as Piastri had joined the party, but Norris, he's the one fading. Tsunoda's the one closing, and look at this. With the DRS assistance, here comes Yuki Tsunoda, our former teammate, up the inside with the Aston Martin power. He's going to go whizzing by in that Honda-powered engine, we should say, of course, and he'll take the position. And in the background, Piastri had gotten past Lando Norris as well. A bit of a surprise to see myself and Lando struggling so much, while our teammates, Verstappen and Russell, have been doing very, very competitive. So it's a bit frustrating, to say the least, to see the comparisons. But nonetheless, we'll breeze around the outside again of Tsunoda into turn number one. I mean, we've got the pace here on the long run, even when he has the rubber advantage, but there's just this continuous, once again, back and forth as we head down this front straightaway. Sonoda's going to get past us into turn number one again with three to go, and I was really at this point just saying, okay, let's just stay in the DRS, line him up for the final lap. It's exactly what we do. White flag in the air here in Zandvoort, up the inside into turn number one. Nearly some contact, washing a little bit wide on the apex there, but the job done here now as we head towards this first end of this first sector. But it's all Aiden Jackson here today. Absolute dominance from the driver in his second season now with McLaren. He picked up his first win last episode, of course, and today he's going to get his second win. Back-to-back victories for Aiden Jackson as he crosses the line to take the victory in Zandvoort. And he pulled away from his teammate of Albon at the end. Albon wasn't even closing. What does that tell you about the pace in Aiden Jackson late in this Grand Prix now, as we are going to head to the line, trying to hopefully hold off Tsunoda. Yes, we will. It'll be P5. A solid day. Wanted more, and I expect more from this Red Bull Ford collaboration. And I think, we're just going to continue to push harder as these races continue to come at us now. And of course, Imola in the next one's hopefully going to be a good day for us as we get driver of the day.
What a great race then, and a magnificent victory here at the Dutch Grand Prix. So, Natalie, What do you think helped them deliver this result?
I really feel the track layout, combined with the track temperatures we saw today, suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
We definitely, you know, have learned that although we're bringing, you know, continuous upgrades, it feels like we're bringing upgrades every episode at this current moment. And we can see the gap on the chart, you know, getting smaller between ourselves and McLaren. It just shows you, though, there's still a long ways to go. That's how well McLaren, you know, came out of the box this season with these regulation changes. And I can confirm we're bringing more upgrades next episode that I think will continue to close that gap between us and McLaren, and it'll be very interesting. Honestly, I think Imola is going to be a key race to see what we have potentially in this Red Bull Ford, but obviously we got to get there and see what we can do. Verstappen still no podium this season. He comes up a bit short today by a few seconds off of Russell there. He ends up fourth, so P5, but we were 11 seconds off our teammate today. I haven't been that far off a teammate in a long time. I feel like since like the Alonso days, you know, back in season two when we went up against him. But we're fifth in the standings as well, 64 back, so we're not really in danger territory yet. It depends, of course, how the season progresses with our pace against the McLarens at this point now, but we're going to continue pushing very, very hard. Third in the constructors, only 1 point behind Mercedes McLaren, way out in front with 198. I'll see you guys in the next one in Imola. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.